everyone. Welcome to Creating Cards with Sherry. I'm Sherry, and I'm so glad that you have joined me today. I got really excited this week because I had to show you. So I had to show you what came in the mail. And I think you'll enjoy it too. It's this month's Paper Pumpkin. So let's get at it. All right, here we go. Welcome to my Tickled Tuesday video. If you're interested in getting this paper pumpkin, you still have a little bit of time. Well, actually, I take that back. This one's done. But I will introduce you to the next one. And if you are interested, you can order it today through July 10th. All right, I would love to be your demonstrator. CreatingCardsWithSherry.stampinup.net is my store. Be sure to put in that host code so that you can get special rewards. And you will find the details of this blog or of this video on my blog. All right, and that is CreatingCardsWithSherry.blogspot.com. All right, let's get started. This is just chucked full with fun things this month. This is called Pick of the Crop. And look at this. Can you believe it? You got a nice little canvas bag. Isn't that cute? I could believe that was in it. I got all excited. All right. You will get some mini dots, and I believe you'll have some, what do they call them? The name escapes me right now. Some glue dots. But I can't find mine. I didn't see mine in here. And so, but I, of course, have some. But you will get some of these mini dimensionals and your glue dots. The stamps are so sweet. They're thinking of you. Love you a whole bunch. You're the pick of the crop and you're the greatest. Of course, there's a big hello and some flowers and berries. And the color is the Calypso Coral that comes with that. And you'll get some twine. All right. Make sure that when you're ready, you have your stamping block. And I'm going to give you another little hint. Oh, I'll give you a couple hints, tips as we go along. So this is our pick of the crop. Paper pumpkin this month. Next month, they have one called Sending Good Thoughts. And you will have, if you order this one, you will have the chance to win a free paper pumpkin kit. So you'll get an additional kit with this if you order by the 10th of July. All right. Again, you can go to my shop to find out how to go about that. And that's creatingcardswithsherry.stampinup.net. All right. Here we go. These are the instructions. It shows you all the different cards. And inside, it shows how to put them together. They were so easy to put together, and they're a lot of fun to do. So let me show you what comes with this kit. Try and kind of dump it out here a little bit. There we go. All right. This comes with 9 cards. And these are the envelopes. They're just so cute the way they put them together. But those are the 9 envelopes. And these are the cards. You'll get one set of 3 that look like this. Another set of 3 that look like this. Isn't that pretty? Ugh, it makes me want to get my blending brushes out. And a set of 3 of these cards. Okay. You will get also a sheet of vellum punch-outs. As you can see, I had to dig into this to do the one that I did today, or the cards that I've done. You'll get some punch-outs, and you also stamp your messages on those. And here's some more punch out, some sweet potato or bread, maybe, and some berries. And then this one, flowers, and a cart. Isn't that cute? Oh, here's my dimensionals. I didn't see them when I first made my cards, or my, not my dimensionals. I'm getting my words mixed up today. My glue dots. All right. So that's what comes in the kit. And I already made three of the cards so that I could just show them to you very quickly. And they were just, like I said, they were easy to make and they were so fun to do. So I'm going to get this out of the way so that I can show them to you. Whoops. All right. Here we go. The first one I did was the one with the cart. And this is how it turned out. Put a little piece that you put one of those breads there. And you stamp your the pick of the crop on there. And one thing that, one tip, if you have a pick your tool tip, you'll want to use your pointy end there to remove all the paper that has been in those wheels. So make sure when you start these that you have your take your pick tool as well. All right. But you, in this, you did took a lot of the punches and you either glued them on or you used the dimensionals. This one has the dimensionals. I don't know if you can tell, but it's separated a little bit from the card. And you put that on that way. Isn't that cute? This whole set reminded me of my sister and my mom. They both love to garden. And I have the black thumb of the family, so I'm not good at it, but they sure are, and I think they would appreciate these cards as well. All right, so that was the first one. The second one, I also took other punch outs, stamped Thinking of You, and this right here, this vellum piece, is an actual bag. I don't know if you can tell. Oh, yeah, the top of it is cut out like a bag, so you put the put your produce in the bag, okay? So I thought that was really cute as well. And then the third one, you made everything 3D in here. These berries are actually printed on here, but you take the punch out and put it on top so it stands out. Isn't that cool? And then you do the Love You a Whole Bunch sign, and when you have those markers that you put in your garden, that's a little marker to show that shows in there. I thought that was really clever as well. And of course, then we have the punch out of these berries. So those are the three cards. I just thought those were so fun. But the highlight of this is that you can also stamp your canvas bag. So I put one together. Isn't that fun? I just think this is the funnest thing. And, you know, you can send it off if you want to for your friends. Just put a card in there and send it off. Or you can put something else in there or just use it yourself for whatever. One tip that I have for this, I would take the piece of cardboard that is in your kit and cut out a piece and put that inside the bag before you stamp, because that will give you a hard surface and allow you to place the stamp carefully on your canvas bag. All right, if you don't do that, it won't show up very well. So that's the other tip that I have for you. Okay. Well, that's it for my Tickled Tuesday video. I'm so glad you joined me. Again, you can have some more information on my blog about this. So be sure to go there to get any more tips and hints. And you take care and have a great week. We will see you for Simple Sunday. Bye now.